Hey Kayla, did you know the 8th of March is International Women's Day? I know it's very hard to believe, but women did not always have the right that they have now. They were denied the right to vote, the right to own land, the right to equal pay, and even to a full education.
Well, I read that a woman named Clara Zetkin, who was a German activist and advocate for women's rights, was one of the first people to start the campaign for National Women's Day.
But why the 8th of March?
Well, it's celebrated on the 8th of March because that day has lots of historical significance. For instance, that was the day when Russian women first got the right to vote. And now we're going to take you over to a young woman, Kelsey Octave.
There's a group of women organizing all-female sailing trips to different bodies of water, testing the ocean surface to see how plastics and toxics affect our bodies.
We're from X Expedition. We're a series of all-female sailing trips around the world, looking at plastics and toxics in our oceans, but also in our own bodies.
So our goal as X Expedition is to raise awareness of the problems we're facing in the oceans and how they relate to us and what we can do together on a community level to solve some of these problems.
How do you plan on solving this problem?
So what we do is we bring together really diverse teams of women from all over the world, from all different backgrounds, walks of life, and different areas of expertise. So the issues that we're dealing with are global issues, global problems, but they also need global solutions. So we try and all work together and collaborate on different ways that we can communicate this issue to different people. And that's at all different levels. It's community level, but it's also business and at policy levels as well. So we do a range of things. We create videos, we write blogs, we go and we give talks like we gave today in your school. And we basically say, we're all in this together. And one of the big things that we really sort of say is the first step towards solving this problem is reducing or eliminating your use of single-use plastic. So things like plastic water bottles, plastic bags, things you're only using once and then throwing away. If we can do that, that's a huge chunk of the problem. And what we're trying to do is not this, there's a huge spectrum of solutions. On one hand, you've got cleaning up the oceans out there, and on the other hand, you've got stemming it at the source. So stopping plastic before it even gets into the oceans. And that's kind of where we fit.
So now I'm going to think about what I throw away, and I hope you do too. This has been Youth Perspective, presented by Blue Frames. See you next time.